All right, guys, this is Mithril, back with another Fallout 3 video. Last time we helped Riley's Rangers, and then we came here to Oasis, and unfortunately we put an end to Harold, the man who got stuck inside a tree. And I'm also encumbered.
Yes, by all means, let's.
Why do I have this? You can also carry that, I guess. No, Lincoln's hat. All right. That's good enough for now. And so our first quest for today is going to be called Stealing Independence. All right. And then we need to go here to Rivet City and look for a Abraham Washington. Somewhere in here. I don't really know where this guy would be, mostly because I don't think I've ever spoken to this guy.
I should get back.
Let me or a security
officer
know.
Everything looks okay
here. No, this Bannon, no.
Yes.
Where's he gonna be? Is he gonna be in the bars in the other place?
Stay chill, dude.
I'm not your dude, bruh. Oh, finding him's gonna suck.
I'll be right with you.
Hello!
Okay, this is like a chapel. He's not in here. Does it tell me on the wiki where he is? I don't... It says he goes to the Capital Preservation. I don't know where that is. The Capital Preservation Society? Where the heck's that? Hey. Oh, it's gotta be in here, right? This has to be it. What time is it? 4 p.m.? He should be here. Somewhere. This has to be the right spot. Here's his door. There he is.
Quite an impressive collection, isn't it?
It's
well,
something.
Don't be shy. Have a look around. Abraham Washington's the name.
I mean, you
curator
got a doghouse.
Little slice of American history.
Yes, it's an interesting collection indeed.
Ah, a fellow scholar, I see. Each of the documents in this room tells a small but important story about the history of the United States of America. Unfortunately, the greatest prize of all is missing from the collection.
All right, I'll bite. What document is missing?
In 1776, the Second Judgmental Congress got together and adopted a document drafted by none other than Thomas Jefferson himself. It was the day the United States of America earned its name and secured its place in history. This magnificent achievement took form in the Declaration of Independence.
Ah, we know about that. We just helped, those slaves get to, you know, settled in at Lincoln's Memorial. If you want me to retrieve the Declaration, all you have to do is ask.
Oh, would you? It would mean so much to me and the Society's collection here.
I'd love to be a part of history and bring you the Declaration.
Excellent! You won't regret it, I promise you. Imagine... You are taking part in another chapter of American history. I envy you. You can find the Declaration of Independence in the ruins of the National Archives.
Are you... Oh, I don't want to give him... I'm not giving him the hat or the repeater. Because I have both on my person, and I'm not going to give it to him.
Good to see you.
Is this a way out? Nope, that's somebody's room. I don't want to do that. That's the way out. From the National Archives. Where, oh where? Is the National Archives? That is a good question to ask right there. That's Vault-Tec. Looks like I'm gonna have to look that up real quick. It's like here somewhere. Because there's the Capitol building. What I'm using right now is actually Lincoln's repeater. Somebody's launching missiles at me. That's not cool.
Oh!
Okay, I think this is the National Archive right here. What are these guys thinking? Wish I had a quest marker though, because I'm sort of going in here blind now.
Get your ass over here if you want to live. Watch out for the mines. Quick, they're coming.
Who's
lock and load? They'll be here any second.
Who? Oh, super mutants? Should have known.
Hang tight. There's always a second wave.
Okay. That was a pretty tough Superman.
Whoa, whoa, careful.
Alright, let's speak to Sydney, I guess.
Say, you're pretty decent in a firefight.
Thanks. You're not so bad yourself.
Well, with what I do for a living, you need to be. Sorry, I'm being a complete asshole. I'm Sydney. It's good to meet a fellow relic hunter.
What do you mean, fellow relic hunter?
Come on. You and I both know this is where the Declaration of Independence is stashed. No need to be coy about it. Good old Abraham Washington sent you on the same suicide mission he sent me on.
Okay.
The only problem is, you're not going to get it without my help.
What are you proposing?
Simple. We pool our resources, grab the declaration, then make for Rivet City and split the reward. I've studied the plans of this place. So without me, you're going to go in circles. What do you say?
All right.
Smart move. Okay. The declaration is secured in the archive's strong room underground. There's a concealed cargo lift right here in the center of the rotunda. I've spent a few days hacking the lock with my remote terminal. When you're ready, punch in the password, let's get going.
What's the password? All right, let's get going. Oh, why? Oh, and there's another one. Where the heck is this thing? I thought the rotunda was that, like, circle we were in. Alright, he was just a regular old Superman.
Found you.
Where the heck did that overlord go?
Keep them pinned.
That's not him. There he is. Alright, looks like we found the elevator.
What's up? There's a cargo lift right here. I was hacking the system right before we were...
We the people. Is there like a terminal I missed? Am I not? Where is the terminal for it then? Is it like upstairs maybe? The terminal for this thing, lady. I hate when they don't have the terminals in like the room.
There's a cargo. I was hacking the system right before.
We of the people. It's not in the ladies' room, is it? Well, somebody, unfortunately didn't survive in there. Is it down here? I'm going to assume, since there's more enemies, maybe? Nice try.
Oh.
Man, don't follow behind me.
No
a cow leg? Oh no. Oh, stop with that. It's a weird audio glitch. Yeah, where is this terminal that you need?
Where? This is the long way down to the east wing. I'd suggest we head back to the rotunda and take the cargo lift.
I tried. I don't know where the terminal is. And you're not helping me with it, so I don't know what to tell you. In a second, I'm just gonna use some editing magic. If I can't find it. Does it have to be here? I don't see no terminal. This terminal don't work. And I don't see a terminal in here anywhere. I don't see no terminal on the walls. Oh, what do you know? I found it. I'm seeing people down here on my mini-map. So close, so close. Okay.
You've breached our defenses, evaded our best soldiers, and you've raided my home.
Button Gwinnett?
But I have not yet begun to fight. I cannot allow you to steal our freedom. The Declaration must remain here. It is our symbol of hope. The one thing that cries out, we are a free nation.
Intelligence, you must be Button Gwinnett, second signer of the Declaration.
Then my reputation precedes me.
I did not know that.
Good. That should make you well aware that I am not to be trifled with, and that my loyalty to the States is legendary. I know your fighting prowess far exceeds my own, but I will still duel you to the death if I must. What will it be, then? Rapiers? Pistols at dawn? Out with it!
That's quite brave of you to potentially sacrifice your life over a document.
This is no mere document, sir. This is the doctrine laid down by my fellow members of the Second Continental Congress.
Oh, Congress,
great. It absolves us of the tyranny of King George III of Great Britain. It is perhaps the greatest symbol of this free nation.
You do realize it's about 500 years later, don't you?
Petty lies and deceit may be the way of Great Britain's crown, but I will not succumb to such tomfoolery. Since it appears you wish to resolve this without bloodshed, may I suggest you stand down and surrender? I can promise that you will be treated well, in a manner accustomed to any member of the Royal Army.
There's more to this than you realize.
Please explain, but I warn you, I am well versed on the tactics of the underhanded redcoat spy.
Yeah, I'm a spy.
To remember that.
Okay, speech of 69%. I'm Thomas Jefferson, and I've returned to liberate the Declaration.
Saints alive! It is both an honor and a privilege, sir. I was hoping this
yes,
day would arrive.
Yes, it is
arrive. I hope these fortifications are
I should have put on my Lincoln hat, said I was Lincoln.
All of my men await your command to push and retake the capital. May I ask where you intend to bring the document?
It will be brought to the State House for safekeeping.
The State House still stands? Then the Stars and Stripes truly are forever. All hail the red, white, and blue. Does this mean the war is over? Have we won?
Yes, we won.
It's over? Amen to that. Then I suppose Amen to my that, posting brother. Here at the fort is complete. I think you said it best when you said, we in America do not have government by the majority. We have government by the majority who participate. It has been both an honor and a privilege to serve in the Army of the United States. What are your final orders?
Stand down and honorably relinquish your post. You've earned a rest.
Coming from you, that means all the world to me. It's been an honor and a privilege to serve my country. It's time for me to take a long-needed rest. I think you'll find that the rest of my men are long due for the same. I hereby relinquish command and control of this fortification to you. Good luck to you, Mr. Jefferson. And give Sally my regards.
Okay, sweet. Imagine Sally was Thomas Jefferson's wife. How do I get in here now? I'll take that wig, thank you very much. It must be here. The Declaration of Independence. Value only one? Do you not know the value of this document? You said it yourself, this is what, absolved us from Great Britain and the tyrant King George III. You see, we wanted to get away from his rule and his taxes, and yet we still have taxes. Okay, luckily, I found where that terminal was to get in there. There's enemies nearby?
Need some help with this one.
We good now? We good.
Yeah, that's over.
Alright, now we gotta go back to this guy's room.
Yes.
Excuse me, Cindy.
Good to see you.
There this guy is. Oh, sorry about that.
What wonderful artifact!
Sydney and I have the Declaration of Independence.
Oh, my lord. I never expect... I mean, I'm utterly shocked.
What, that she was alive?
You two have earned your places in the annals of American history. Yes, indeed. You will be remembered for this great day. I will award Sydney's promised bounty to her personally. No need to worry yourself about that.
Uh-huh.
Enjoy your reward, my friend. You've earned it. What's the big idea?
Okay, now I got a railway rifle schematic.
What's up? You know, I think I'm just gonna kick.
Okay, I'm gonna save, because she has a weapon that is technically unique. Alright, now our next one, we have to go to Ten Penny Tower. Well, technically the next one on the list would be helping the slavers of Paradise Falls, and I don't really want to do that. So we are going to Ten Penny Tower, which is down here.
You can tell Ten Penny he can kiss my ass. We've got plenty of bottle
caps. I think Roy is one of the guys I need to talk to.
We have to go through this.
So leave me alone.
You're not getting in.
I can stand here all day yelling at you through this damn speaker if I have
to. Who's shooting?
I've already told you Tenpenny won't allow zombies to live here.
Who the hell are you talking about?
I could have sworn I heard bullets fly.
That's for damn sure. For the last time,
something just blew up.
No zombies allowed.
Can't you tell the difference between me and a fairy?
Where the heck was that? Oh, it's right over here. Something died right there. Alright. He's one of the guys. Okay, I guess not.
I thought I told you to get the hell out of here. Tenpenny doesn't want your goddamn caps.
Another guy we need to talk to is Gustavo.
Last time, get your rotten, ugly, goddamn ghoul ass off Mr. Tenpenny's private property.
Is this how you treat all your guests?
What? No, just those damn ghouls. Sorry, thought you were one of them. Ghoul or not, I must inform you that you are trespassing on Alistair Tenpenny's private property. Renters and official business only.
I can take care of that little ghoul problem for you.
Is that so? And why should I believe that? You ever kill a ghoul before?
I've pretty much hunted everything the waste has to offer. Yeah, I kill ghouls and rent-a-cots with attitudes who ask too many questions.
Oh, looks like we got a live one here. I think we better leave this one outside. Goodbye, kid. Try not to get eaten by anything out there.
Leave me alone.
You again?
Yeah. 100 caps.
Fit in around here better than I thought. All right, I'll take your money, but don't press your luck. I got my eye on you. Don't bother Tenpenny or the other residents. If you so much as sneeze in the wrong direction, I'll gut you.
See you later.
Welcome to Ten Penny
there
Tower.
There he is.
Don't do anything stupid. You got something to say?
Yeah. How's that ghoul situation coming along?
That damn Roy Phillips won't take no for an answer. Keeps showing up, looking for a handout. He and his kind aren't wanted.
Listen, man. Story.
If I were
there were people
man,
once.
I'd place a stack of caps on him trying something violent soon. And that would make Tenpenny nervous. I don't like it when Tenpenny gets nervous. But I can't spare the manpower to go hunt down Roy Phillips and his band of misfits, or I'd gladly end this thing once and for all.
I can help you out with your ghoul problem. Where are they hiding?
Really? You? You're welcome to
yes,
give it a try.
Me.
But don't come crying to me when you get hurt. They've holed up in the nearby metro tunnels. They're living with packs of feral ghouls. Be careful. Roy seems damn close to turning zombie himself. I suppose you won't be doing this out of the kindness of your heart, hmm? How's 500 bottle caps sound? Payable upon termination of that damn ghoul, Roy Phillips, and all his followers.
You want this problem resolved or not? You can spare more than that.
Well, maybe you're right. It was something I was going to have to do eventually anyway. How about another 200 caps?
All right, 700, I can take that.
You can take this rifle and ammo. But you better not screw this up. Roy Phillips and his gang are somewhere in Warrington Station metro tunnels. They've barred the main entrance. Try going through the train yard.
Alright. Oh, I didn't see what he gave me. A 44? Combat shotgun. So the reason why they call them zombies is because after, you know, the bombs fell, some people were affected by the radiation causing them to lose all their skin and hair, and it makes them unfortunately look like you know, zombies. And then another reason why they call them that is because ghouls, even though they can live a long life, like hundreds and years of stuff, eventually their minds like decompose and they eventually go feral. Oh, it's an Awkwafina Brahmin. How'd this happen? Oh, I think I found out how that happened. Yeah, so while being a ghoul can make you, like, almost immortal, eventually you do go feral. It just, you know, some might take a year, some might take 1,000 years, you never know. I wonder if you did, like, word puzzles or something to get, you know, to get your brain active. If it would make your brain stronger, that way it'd take a longer time. That'd be something to ask Todd Howard. Ooh, that's bright. Hello? Housekeeping. What? I'm hitting in like an invisible wall. And now I'm missing every single shot. What is that? A roamer? Weird, there's like an invisible wall right here or something. How does air smell dangerous? What are you smelling, gas? Ah! Oh, I need to reload. Get him. Or not. Yeah. There we go. It's a little tight quarters here. Oh, that's a Reaver. Hold on, I'm gonna have to pull out the, there we go. The Gatling laser for him. Since they're so ridiculously strong. Really? Hey, yes, you got him then, right, Fox? How'd I miss that? There we go. Here looks like the compound.
I'm not playing around. Come on,
Michael Masters.
We need to have a little chat. I don't want to waste bullets on your sorry hide.
I don't want to take bullets out of them. I'm here to see Roy Phillips.
Oh yeah? Is he expecting you? Well then, run along. It's not wise to keep Roy waiting. Has a bit of a temper, that one. You watch yourself.
All right, no problem.
Good luck.
So I do know the outcome for these decisions, depending on what you want to do. Where the heck is this guy?
What are you doing here?
Just passing through.
Just passing through. It's...
Looks like I gotta go this way? Maybe? Maybe it loops back around? No, that's not it. What is this, like a watchtower? Do I have to go down below? Here we go. Oh, it's a baby carriage. What, is there only two ghouls down here? How the heck? What a convoluted little place to get down to. It's pretty complex. Bessie Lynn and Roy Phillips. Morning. Wake up, Roy.
What do you want?
Gustavo hired me to kill you.
Is that so? He isn't man enough to do it himself? Sends a boy to do his dirty work.
Watch that word.
You think you got what it takes?
Relax. It's just a warning, not a threat. I'm not gonna kill you. I don't have to kill you if you were to give me a handful of caps.
You picked the wrong ghoul to fuck with, kid.
Alright, I guess we're killing him. And I missed. Point blank, and I missed. Trying to kill me with a switchblade. Science. And I guess Energy weapons. What kind of perk is this? So basically every 10 Nuka-Colas you have in your inventory get converted into a Nuka-Cola Quantum. What? Like, sir? What? Sure, we go a little leaguer, I guess. I didn't really want to kill him. But I guess that's what we're doing. Sorry about that, Michael. Now, do I have to go back the same way I came? Yep. There's not a back entrance. What about this way? That goes somewhere. Oh, it's a Reaver. Okay, kind of a wasted trip over here. Great. Just great. Now we gotta go back the way we came. Yeah, so I guess they'll tell you the two different paths you could take. So, the path we're on now is basically you kill the ghouls and that's it, they die. And let's see, what do we get? We get our caps and assault rifle, and then that's kind of it. Maybe like a little bit of rep with Tenpenny Tower. But if we were to help the ghouls instead of Tenpenny Tower and find a way for them to be able to... Oh, that's a different way. And if they find a way to coexist... If you come back after like 3 days or a week or something, all the humans are dead. Roy's like, oh yeah, we had to get rid of them. It was a new management kind of thing. And so they basically kill all the non-ghouls in the tower. Why didn't we just go this way? That would have been so much quicker. Yeah, and then Roy would have gave us ghoul mask, which makes us like invisible to ghouls, because they just assume you're one of them. Feral ghouls, I mean, not actual like human ghouls. Ferals will just be like, nope, that guy's a ghoul. I can see his face. It looks like Freddy Krueger's butt cheek. Yo, open up. Do I have to do this?
Keep your panties on. Morning.
Where is Gustavo? There he is.
Tenpenny Tower.
Hey. Didn't think you had it in.
Well, guess what I did.
Guess you proved me wrong. Good job. Knowing those ghouls are gone takes a load off my mind. Thanks.
No problem.
You'll be wanting the reward now.
Yes, I will.
I suppose you've earned it. There's your caps. Contract fulfilled, debt paid. This don't mean we're buddies, all right? Now get going.
All right. There we go. That's our two mission quota for the day. I could go for a third one, but then... The thumbnail would be full of just text and junk and stuff. But anyways, if you guys have enjoyed today's video, make sure to leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe, because it'll help out my channel. And I will appreciate it like always. And then down in the description below are my socials. Make sure to follow me there. But, all right, guys, this is Mithril. I'll be seeing you guys in the next one. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim.